Visit my Facebook page for a chance to get a free custom logo animation. Win chance is high because we are just starting the business. Hey fellow animators, I am Miloš Černý. There is obviously a huge amount of keyboard shortcuts in 3ds Max, and you will probably discover many of them as you go. It wouldn't make much more sense to just go through them one by one here and mention all of them. However, let's take a look at those which I use. Let's start with the general ones. Beside viewport navigation, which is of course mandatory, Q, W, E and R are the next basic ones. I am not going to talk too much about these ones because even the beginners know these, but they are important to mention at least. They are for transformations. Q for selection, W for position, E for rotation and R for scale. You will use them a lot and you shouldn't ever go up here and change these gizmos manually. For different views in viewports, you have this cube here, but that will still keep you in a perspective view. You can use F for the orthographic front view, T for the top one, L for the left, and P to get back to the perspective. I use these a lot as well. Sometimes you see silhouettes a bit better in orthographic views, sometimes it's useful even for animating. But I bet you can think of 100 examples by yourselves where these views are useful. So let's quickly move on. Z or Z key is very important. It focuses your current selection. Every time you just get lost in a viewport or the viewport camera is not doing what you expect it to, just hit Z, zoom out a bit and you are set. But now to the most important thing you need to have. Changing between local and view coordinate systems. It's the drop down you have here on the top of the screen. I'm sure you know what it does, but for those who don't, it changes the transformation gizmo according to what you have set. So if you have a box like this and you rotate it, with the default view mode, the gizmo is basically aligned to the world one. However, if you now change it to local coordinate system, you can see the gizmo changed and it's aligned to the local axis of the box, which is extremely useful when animating. If you want to rotate this hand and change it to thumbs down for example, with gizmo set to view, it would be kind of hard to do. But with local, it's just rotation around one axis. There are also more options in the drop-down menu, but you can explore those by yourself. The default view one and the local one are those I use the most. But the problem is, they don't have a keyboard shortcuts for them. So let's also take a look how to set those up. Go to Customize and Customize User Interface. Here under Keyboard, Main UI and All Commands, click on the list of options and start typing local. Find local coordinate system. And you can see I already have a Shift plus W set for it, which is what I use. You will not have anything here, so just click on the hotkey here, press Shift plus W and hit Assign. Go back to the Options window and start typing View. Find View coordinate system and assign Shift plus Q, like I have here, or anything you would like to have. With this setup, you can now easily switch between those two and it will speed up your work significantly. Another important shortcut by default is Alt plus A, which is for aligning objects. It's the button up here, but I use it so often that the shortcut comes in handy. You also saw me use Align several times in my tutorials before, and I guess you can imagine why it is useful, especially if you use helpers for any kind of work. And the last ones I wanted to mention are dot and comma next to the M key, for previous and next frame on the timeline. You should probably move these shortcuts to be somewhere closer to your left hand, and I should as well, but I am already so used to these ones that I just left them like they are. Anyway, as I said, there are of course many more shortcuts in 3ds Max and a lot of important ones, but I wanted to make a quick video of what I generally use, just for your information. General rule is that any particular activity you do often should be ultimately set to some keyboard shortcut, if it's not already. Because it will obviously speed up your workflow. However, I had a colleague that was doing everything in 3ds Max with just the mouse, without any keyboard shortcuts. Even the viewport manipulation. And he was a better animator than I am. But that's not really an argument for not using keyboard shortcuts. Which ones do you use though? Let me know in the comments. If you need any work done that has animations in it, hire us at miemotion.com. Thank you and thank you to all my Patreons. See you in another video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.